In this interactive simulation, we're looking at oxidation of carbon monoxide in an isothermal plug flow reactor. And what we have the options of changing are the temperature in the reactor and then the feed concentrations. In this case, we're using a 1-to-1 feed concentration. And then here we're plotting the pressure, the partial pressure in the reactor as we move down the reactor. So we can see we're reacting carbon monoxide. And because the stoichiometry's 1 CO to 1/2 oxygen, but we're feeding 1-to-1, then react on essentially all the carbon monoxide and half of the oxygen. Here's the CO2 that we're making. And so what the simulation does is also show us what is the coverage on the catalyst of carbon monoxide and oxygen atoms as a function of distance down the reactor. Because their heats of adsorption are different, their competition for sites is such that carbon monoxide tends to have a higher coverage on the surface. And then here we're plotting the rate of reaction as a function of distance down the reactor. So now let's look at the interactive simulation. In this simulation, we are plotting the partial pressures of carbon monoxide and oxygen, and I can change the relative amounts, so I can increase the oxygen partial pressure, and this changes how quickly the carbon monoxide reacts. If I look at the coverages, notice that at the beginning of the reactor, the catalyst is mostly covered with carbon monoxide, a much smaller amount of oxygen because carbon monoxide adsorbs more strongly. And then as the carbon monoxide reacts away, as its partial pressure decreases and its loading decreases and coverage decreases, then the coverage of oxygen increases significantly, and also the coverage of vacant sites increase. And as a result, if we look at the rate, we see that the rate actually goes through a maximum. So the rate's increasing, even though the partial pressures of both reactants decrease. And so the idea here is that we can change, of course, the partial pressures and the point where we use up all the carbon monoxide changes. We can also change the temperature, and that pushes the reaction out to longer distances because the rate constant's lower. If I increase the temperature, now you notice we get a very sharp maximum and a very sharp change in the relative coverages. And so the Langmuir-Hinshelwood mechanisms, where essentially carbon monoxide is inhibiting oxygen adsorption and slowing down the rate over what it would be if more oxygen could adsorb on the surface. And the simulation helps you to visualize what's happening in these Langmuir-Hinshelwood mechanisms.